So what is up guys, this is Karan here, back with another video. Welcome back to Tech Karan YouTube channel. We've installed Dovefest Custom Room, the latest build with the July security patch. You can see I've just installed Dovefest 10 official on my Redmi Note 8 Gingko. This build has a lot of things. How about this build? How's the camera? How's the performance? A lot more things I am gonna share with you in this video. Make sure to watch this video till the end to understand everything. I'm gonna share with you the Geekbench score, the camera performance, and a lot more things. This build is officially and unofficially available for a lot of devices. I'll provide you the link in the description. So with that get said, let's get started. Okay, so first of all, we're gonna start with the home screen and the launcher. The launcher which you get here by default is the launcher pre-installed, and as you can see, launcher is actually based on Pixel Launcher, which has some great customization options. As you already know about, you can customize your theme, desktop, home widget, dock, app drawer, a lot more things. This is one of the great things and one of the best customizable launcher ever. The build is super duper smooth. As you can see, it's just great. It's official build, so it's available for a lot of devices, and it's good for almost all of the devices. It has some customization options also. If you're seeing my control center, actually the quick settings panel where you get these kind of quick setting tiles with the header image, you can customize a lot of header images also. And you can see my footer text hashtag Techkaran, and you can edit these kind of things also. Click here, you have a lot of extra tiles options which include Dovefest, hotspot, screen record, and peak notifications is the thing which you get in Dovefest custom room. We get the dark theme option, gaming mode, screen stabilization, AOD, and a lot more things. These are the things you can customize in settings also. Now let's move on to some other things. Okay, so if we talk about the camera, by default camera which you get here is this normal Snapdragon camera. For me, for Redmi Note 8, it's normal Snapdragon camera. But for other devices, you can check out for your device, you can get Mi camera or some other things also. I have also installed the Gcam 7.4, the latest Gcam, which has all the features perfectly fine, including HDR+, which is one of the great things ever. You can choose the portrait mode, you can choose the night sight, normal camera things, where you get a lot of things, HDR and etc., which you get Google Lens suggestions also. This is Gcam 7.4 by Parrot, which I'm using right now. And if you also want to use Gcam 7.4, I'll provide you the link in the description so that you can use the Gcam 7.4 right now on your device. If you're also wondering, I have the new switches. The switches I cannot change now. And if you want to use these kind of switches, you can customize these things in settings. Okay, now let's move on to the Magisk manager. We have installed the Magisk 20.4, but unfortunately the CTS profile is false, which means maybe you'll get some difficulties in using banking apps. So it's recommended for you to use Magisk 20.3 if you want to use banking apps. And if you are still using Magisk 20.4, you can try out Magisk Hide, maybe that works for you, but not sure about that. And as safety net is not passed, which means your device is also not certified. Yes, we have device is not certified thing here. So device is not certified. So let's move on to some other things right now. Okay, let's move on to the Geekbench score. I have tried out the Geekbench score for my device. My device is actually showing Google Pixel 4 XL right now for me, but the Geekbench score is just great for my device. It's 318 is the single core score and 1357 is the multi-core score, which is one of the great things. Average, my device got 300 in the single core and I got 318. And talking about the multi-core score, average we got 1300 and now we got 1357, which is far better than the previous one, which means good performance in gaming, multitasking, and a lot more things. There are a lot of benefits available. And if you're checking out my icons here, my status bar icons are also changed here. My launcher icons are also changed. These are from styles and wallpaper, which you can customize. There are a lot of options available. In styles and wallpapers, we have the alive wallpapers options are available too. But unfortunately, if you use the live wallpapers, you might get some lag. So live wallpapers are not fully compatible, but you have Google wallpapers pre-installed. So there are a lot of wallpapers which you can customize. And I'm using Wally, the wallpaper app for my device. So that's interesting. And as you can see, the wallpaper is just nice. Now let's move on to some other things. Moving on to settings, we have Durfest room, which means we got a lot of customization options. But before that, let's check out some other things. Like in battery options, we have great battery backup. I'm using from past 12 to 13 hours. It's just perfectly fine. And the battery temperature it's showing here is a very helpful thing nowadays. This time it's summer for me, and I just need to check out my battery temperature again and again. It's perfectly fine and quite great thing. If we talk about the display settings, we have the lock screen display options, we have adaptive brightness, screen timeout options, and some switches customization options which you might get in Durfest customizations. Actually, we have the display cutout settings, where when you click this cutout style, we can hide the status bar notch if we want to, but I'll not hide that because that will not look better now. Right now it's just looking good. We have density customizations, and at last we have some themings, which includes dark theme, primary color, and you can also customize fonts. There are a lot of fonts options available, like Samsung One Pixel font and Slate, some other things, and these fonts are quite great. You can use any fonts from here. These look pretty much impressive. We have icon shape and status bar icons. I'm using the circular one, which is looking good. And if I choose the fade option, the status bar icons might be changed. As you can see, my status bar icons are changed and looking now a little bit of different and little bit of interesting. Moving on to some other things, we have sound, storage, privacy, location. Everything is just perfectly fine. These are the kind of same things like digital well-being and parental controls, which have digital well-being tools and parental control tools options are available too. About phone, as I already shown you, it's Pixel 4 XL. My device is showing likes, so it's all depend upon your device. I'm using the Durfest official build for my Redmi Note 8. Moving on to Durfest official custom ROM features right now. Okay, so moving on to Durfest customization options, which include theming, status bar customizations, quick settings, buttons, gestures, lock screen, power menu notifications, animations, miscellaneous, and about. These are kind of things you get in DurfQuest, which is Durfest customization things. So let's move on to these things one by one. First of all, we have theming options, where you can select out themes, which is styles and wallpapers. We have accent preset. We have the switch style, which I have applied the narrow one. If you click the OnePlus, you will get OnePlus style switches here. If you click this one and click 2MD2, you'll get these kind of switches. So this is kind of great thing. You can customize your device switches, use framework values, and these kind of things. Now we have status bar customization options, which include system icons, status bar logo, which I'm using. We have some clock settings customization options. We have some notifications customization options, and etc. include battery bar. And at last, we have carrier label customization options included, which includes carrier label on lock screen, or you can customize your customized carrier label. You can change the carrier label font, color, and size. Now let's move on to some other things. We have quick settings, which you can check out. I have the option enable the status bar pull down from the quick settings from left side. If I click here, I'll get the expanded quick settings like this, and if I click from here, I'll get these kind of quick settings here. This is the option which you can customize left side, right side, or anywhere. It all depends upon your preferences. Enable quick setting tiles, tint style, override default colors, header image. As you can see, I am also using header image, which looks perfectly fine. Aquaman, I am using this one. You can customize also select header image. There are a lot of images available, like this one, and some other packs include these kind of things. You can customize any header image from here. There are a lot. It all depends upon you. These kind of great things you can customize in Durfest custom room. Like here you have the tiles area, footer area, and header area. Now we have buttons customizations, which include navigation bar customizations, volume customizations, which include playback control, which is kind of a great thing, and a normal feature, daily life uses feature. We have some gestures options, which include AOSP gestures, and it has system navigation gestures. I'm using full screen gestures. These are working perfectly fine. We have three finger gesture options available too. This might work. Yes, this is perfectly working. We have lock screen customizations, include power menu customizations, which include advanced restart, screenshot, and some other things. Notifications include notifications, light, charging, animation, heads up, edge lighting. A lot of extra features are there. So that's a kind of great thing that you can use these kind of features on a custom room. And this is kind of great thing, which is officially and unofficially available for a lot of devices. You should try out this build because this is one of the greatest and smoothest ever build I'm using from some time. It's just perfectly fine. It's great. You should try out this build. So this was all from today's video. This was my recommendations about Dorfest official custom ROM. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Goodbye. Have a nice day.